So I honestly don't know what the Conservative Party in Canada is doing for their strategy, and this is a good example of why they were gonna lose anyways, because their platform just doesn't make any fucking sense. But recently they just all voted to remove the birthright citizenship in Canada, right? And this is the same thing that happens in America, right? Where a couple of illegals come into the country and they have a baby, and now that baby is a citizen of America. They do the same thing in Canada, and it's essentially an anchor baby that now they use that to bring their whole family across the border. Or now their kid has dual citizenship, so they can just bring them back and forth to their country, and then when they get old enough, they can send them to Canada to benefit off of all of our fucking resources when they don't even live in the country. And people are doing this. A lot of people from China are doing this to Canada. They're just exploiting this, and initially in America and stuff, this law was started for slaves and to make them citizens and their kids citizens, which was a good thing because, yeah, they've been living there for hundreds of years. They deserved to be citizens. But now we no longer need things like this. Everybody here that is here now, should be here. And people coming in from other countries to have their kids born here and exploit the system, that should not be going on anymore. And I completely agree with the conservatives doing this, but it makes no sense to me that they would go on this topic and vote on this and be one of the only parties to actually go after this in a long time, but at the same time condemn Maxime Bernier for his statements about multiculturalism and him pointing out all these things. Right? Like, it just makes absolutely no sense because this right here, going after that, is going to be viewed as even worse than what Maxime Bernier said. So I don't get their strategy. It's like, let's go all the way here, but not completely. Let's pull back a little bit here, a little bit there. Let's go full force here. Like, what the fuck are you doing? It's like they're eventually going to concede, to Maxime Bernier and admit that everything that he is talking about is right and correct. But they do shit like this, and like look at Jagmeet Singh, and I've seen a lot of people say this very same thing, like the leader of NDP. He's like, CPC 18 delegates voted in favor of ending birthright citizenship for children born in Canada unless one parent is Canadian or a permanent resident. So it's not even all the way. It's like a permanent resident still gets to have kids, and their kids become citizens, right? So they're not citizens, but they're, I guess, permanent resident, whatever the fuck that specifically means, but I guess it's somebody that's right below the tier or something. But even he's like, even Trump has resisted this idea. The NDP unequivocally condemns the division and hate being peddled by Andrew Scheer and the CPC. See, so this is what I'm talking about Andrew Scheer condemning Maxime Bernier, saying his comments are racist or whatever. He doesn't represent the values of the Conservative Party. When you are gonna be labeled a racist, a bigot, anyways. And some people hear me say this and they think that, oh, I want people just to be racist and to say bigoted things and to say, like, oh, black people are this and be really racist towards natives. It's like, no, that's not what I'm saying, okay? When I say people need to stop being politically correct, that doesn't mean, oh, we should be able to call black people the N-word as much as we want. Like, that's just, I don't know, a very simplistic view of, political correctness or what it's really what we're really talking about. It's like, no, we're talking about having the right or having people not freak out at you when you say stuff like men and women are different. Fat isn't healthy for you. Maybe it's not a good idea to replace white people and shit. Like, things like this. This is what I'm talking about. Things that are not politically correct. Like, you know, calling somebody who is overweight and dying, saying that, hey, you're killing yourself because you're eating yourself to death, right? Being straightforward. I'm not saying, oh, we need to attract all the racists and stuff by saying, we don't want minorities in a country because they stink and stuff like that, right? It's like, no. You know, I have my positions, and the reason I think white people should stay a majority has nothing to do because I think, you know, these people are this or that. You know, it's because I think this is going to lead to a more stable society. And that's pretty much it. So I'm not trying to attract racists, neither is Maxime Bernier or anything like that. But because of what we're talking about, people that are further right, some of them are going to like it. You know, that's just the way it's going to be, you know, okay? But that doesn't mean what we're saying is hateful. Doesn't mean what Andrew Scheer wants to do right here and remove that citizenship thing. Doesn't mean he's hateful and bigoted and whatever. It's because people are abusing our system. You know, they are coming over here and, yeah, having kids here and then, like, going back home and then sending their kids back and forth, using up everything that we have created for our own children. You know, it's not right for you, for any national, if any foreigner person who does this, who has done this, is watching my channel, like, you're a piece of shit. Honestly, even if the country allows you to do this, and it's the rules, and it's okay to do, you know that that's not right. You know it's not good to abuse a country's laws like this and to benefit yourself. That is horrible, you know, to do that. And these things, they cost Canadians millions and millions and millions of dollars every year. Cost doctors and hospitals millions of dollars because people come here, they have their kids, and they're supposed to pay for it. You know, it's like the Canadian government, they allow this. They're like, well, as long as you pay the $1,000 to $10,000 and this and that for the hospital fees, you can come here and have your kid, and then the kid will become a citizen. But oftentimes, people, they don't pay it, okay? They don't pay it, and it costs even more than what we think it's going to cost, and then they just go back home, you know? So it's like we're just the ones getting fucked for this. And we don't need a law like this anymore, making it so two people who are not citizens of Canada, their kids is now a citizen. Like, that makes no sense for us to have this. It makes no sense for Americans to have it. This is what is driving a lot of illegal immigration and stuff to these countries anyways, because you can just go there, have an anchor baby, and then there you go. There's your free ticket into this country. And that's bullshit. Okay, this country is for Canadians. Canadians first. We come first. Immigrants come second, okay? Like, enough of this global world bullshit, because nobody thinks that way. Everybody cares about their family and their friends above everybody else. You know, don't lie to yourselves, people. You know, when you see somebody die, and it's far away, and you have very little connection, you don't feel that much. You don't give a shit most of the time. You care, yeah. If your brother died, your sibling, somebody, you've a friend, then you do care, right? You care about these people more, as it should be. You know, if we cared, if we cried and moaned every time somebody died that had absolutely no connection to us, we would be insane. We would go crazy. So it makes sense. It's only natural for us to worry about Canada and Canadians first, and to stop being the breadbasket of the world. Stop coming into Canada and taking advantage of our country. And I don't give a fuck about this. Oh, I'll get somebody in the comments. Well, you took the land from the natives and blah, 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 blah. Get out of here. Go fuck yourself. Every goddamn nation on earth right now has been taken over from somebody else. All the places in Africa and all these other places had different types of natives living there beforehand, that these other groups came and took them over. Okay, so, you know, in Canada, the way it is now, with all the infrastructure, the resources, and all the wealth that is created, was created by Europeans. Okay, that's who was created by. The wealth was generated by them, the ideas, the structure, you know, the civilization, the everything was set in place by them. Okay, so it belongs to them. And yes, we took it from Aboriginals and stuff, but there was a lot of treaties and deals, and sure, you know, some of them we didn't all fully follow, and I'm not saying we treated Aboriginals great, and there was definitely, you know, I'm against statism in general. So yes, the state, the government did a lot of bad things in the past and stuff too, right? But that still doesn't take away the fact that it was Europeans and stuff who came here, settled here, and created this fucking country. My ancestors came here, had a little plot of land. They were given a little plot of land with nothing, right? They had to live in an overturned fucking wagon until they built their house from scratch, tilled all the land from scratch, and then after years and years of making that land usable and profitable, then it was given to them. Then it became their property. But it's not like shit just pops out of nowhere. Wealth doesn't just appear. It takes time. It takes years. And we didn't get it all through exploitation or anything like that. So we Canadians that are here now are deserving of the spoils of our country. And it's bullshit that we have people coming over here, having anchor babies, abusing the system, stealing our money, because that's what it is. Because even if it's legal and you're allowed to do it, it's still not right. You know, there are many things that are legal that are not right. There are many things that are legal which are right to do. So, you know, the whole legalese argument, it does not fucking fly. It comes down to morality. Are you okay with going in somebody else's home and taking their shit and abusing it and stealing from them? Is that okay to do? No, it's not okay to do. Right? So let us take care of our own people first. Stop taking advantage of it. And yes, the government allows it, and they are pieces of shit, and they are creating the incentive. But at the end of the day, there are many incentives in life and society, and we do have a choice whether or not to follow those incentives and to take them. You know, there are some people, they grow up in really bad neighborhoods with lots of crime and all this shit, and they don't become drug dealers. They don't do this. They decide to go stay in the room and read a book instead. They make different choices, okay? And they could have the choice to go and take advantage, go rob a store, go make some easy money by taking advantage of somebody, but they don't, because they're good people and they want to be good, upstanding citizens. And anybody who comes to Canada and abuses the system, has like a dual citizen baby and shit, like, fuck you, you're a piece of shit. I don't like you. Don't tell me that you do that, because they'll just piss me off. And, you know, you should leave Canada. You should stay in your own fucking country. Make your own country good. If like, why becoming like a lot of it is coming from China too. Like it is primarily from them. In a lot of places, because, you know, Canada is stupid and we let them take advantage of us. But, you know, like, no more. Like, I agree with the conservatives doing this, but like I said, they're stupid, because they're going to be demonized for this. You know, look in America when they try to make people show their ID for voting. You know, it's clearly not racist, but it gets spun into the most racist, bigoted thing ever. Same with this. That's why it makes no sense to me why Andrew Scheer, if he's going to be in support of this, why didn't he support everything Maxime Bernier was saying, right? Because, you know, he's paid off. It's just the conservatives, they're trying to give us, a lot of these politicians, trying to just make us pretend like we have an option between two people. But really, we don't. They're very similar. And, you know, who knows if he would even actually follow through on this the way they are. I highly doubt that they would. The only person that I trust running that shit at this point right now is Maxime Bernier, because he, you know, he's saying this, all this shit, before it's popular. He's saying this shit and he's risking his own fucking back because of it, his own ass. Like, people are saying, oh, he's doing it for his own benefit. He's doing it because he wants, you know, he's mad and he's bitter and all this shit, and he's doing it for his own popularity. It's, are you kidding me? It's like, you know, he's never going to be allowed in the Conservative Party ever again. This wasn't for his own benefit. He said it because he believes it. And like I said in another video and stuff, like, now even when Andrew Scheer and all this stuff, they come and they backpedal to this. It's like, I don't trust you. You know, you're just going with what's popular. So you can never, ever fucking trust people like that. And if he ever condemns supply management, which, you know, we shall see. I don't think he ever will. You know, it will be too late on that too. You know, you were silent on it for too long. And we know where your loyalties lie. Okay, it's not to the people, it's not to your principles, it's not to your core. It's who can give you power, it's who can get you into the positions you need to get. And you know, I don't want people like that in our politics, running our country. I want somebody like Maxim, who already believes in these things and who actually wholeheartedly thinks this way. These people are much more trustworthy than somebody like Andrew Scheer can ever be. And this is why, under Andrew Scheer, the Conservative Party have no chance. Even if Maxime Bernier stayed silent or anything like that, they have no chance with a dumbass fucking strategy like this. And them not understanding that the media, man, is on Trudeau's side. Like, come on, guys. Are you willfully ignorant or something? Anything you do is going to be spun, okay? Even if you think you're not being racist or anything, it's going to be spun, okay? So just remember that. So you may as well just be fucking forthright. You may as well just say what needs to be said. But that's all I really had to say. If you like my content, subscribe and have a good day. See ya.